15 minutes and then you have to just start again. Okay, so that CD player, obviously plays, so you just put it in, that's the eject button. Mm-hmm. And then you've got an eject button there, which ejects the whole front of the radio off if you want to keep it secure as well. Like that one, switch it on and off. Okay?
Yep.
Right. Okay, so just above our heads, as you come into the van, that's your main control panel. Obviously, it's nothing too complicated on there. The control panel's asleep at the moment. Obviously, you can see bits of lights and things are on at the moment, so that shows everything switched on. I can press any button, it just shows you what is on. So power, that's your switch, your 12 volt system's on and off. That switches your water pump on and off. That's showing you've got 240 connected. That shows you your laser battery connected.
Yep.
Obviously, you saw that there then. Press a view level. That shows you what your laser battery's doing.
Right.
So obviously showing, well, it's our battery at the moment, obviously. Yeah. But it's showing 14 volts because it's going through a charger. Not your normal battery, if you weren't connected to electric, you would run about 12, 13, obviously, well charged. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, switch your 12 volt systems on off. All you do is just press that. That's all your 12 volt system's off. Right. Press it, and that switches it all on.
Okay, so when you go into the on the main, like if you plug it on the mains, you won't need to.
No, you still need to switch that on. That still switches things on.
Okay, so yeah. It takes over.
Yeah, 240. 240 will only go direct to your microwave straight away. That's the only thing you'll see that will come on 240 straight away.
Right.
Unless you've got your charge on, obviously that will come on straight away and start charging, which you obviously can't see that.
Okay. So that, it automatically sorts out the 240 volt in from the battery.
That's it. Yeah, but you need to switch it on to have the systems on.
Lovely.
Even though it is only 12 volts, but it is switching everything on.
Lovely.
Okay, so first thing we need to do when we get into the van is normally get the water system up and running.
Yep.
So in this corner over here is your boiler and your heater.
Yep.
Okay, and if you can see that, you can't, it's difficult to see for that, but
yeah,
you can see that yellow lever there.
Yep.
That is the drain for the water system.
Okay.
Okay, and the position it's in at the moment allows water to run around the system.
Yep.
If you lift it up, so it's pointing upwards, that'll just drain it down onto the ground outside.
Okay.
So obviously if you drained that tank previously, obviously you need to get it into that position before you start trying to get water in.
Okay.
Otherwise you'll just enter the aqua roll just underneath the van.
Yeah.
You'll end up with just a big puddle.
Okay.
Okay?
Yep.
Right, while we're down here, I'll just show you your consumer unit, which is this one here. Okay, yep. We've got lights on the top right, they're all switches.
Yep.
Spare, obviously, is not connected to anything. Heating the hot water, that's your isolator for your electric, for your heating the hot water.
Yep.
Charge button, that's your charger button, so you switch that on and off. You can just leave it switched on.
Yeah.
And that will charge your battery.
Yep.
Next one is just a light, reverse polarity.
Yep.
What that does is, obviously checks if it's reverse polarity. If you go on the continent, they tend to wire things slightly differently than us, okay? So if you plug your 240 in and come in here and have a look, if that is lit, it is reversed, and you're going to need an adapter to operate off their electrics.
Okay.
Okay? So that's all it is, just a warning. It won't damage anything, just pull your electrics out, and then it should be okay.
Okay.
Okay, bottom right, 240 trips, okay?
Yeah.
Info note there to say what they're connected to.
Yeah.
Bottom left, 12-volt fuses.
Yeah.
Again, what they're connected to is on there.
Is it worth carrying spare fuses, then?
You've probably got one or two in your pack.
Okay.
I've never changed any fuse in my van. I've had a van for 9 years, but normally they're pretty good, but it probably is worth having the odd. With getting water into the van, so the first thing you need to check is make sure all the taps are shut.
Yep.
Because the last thing you want to do is water coming in where you don't want it coming in.
Okay.
Once you check that, obviously you check your drain there, is then switch your water pump on. That's on, you see the little green light on.
Okay.
Okay, all you do is just open the taps. What you're doing opening the taps is getting the air out of the system. Okay, so if you drain the water system down previously, all the pipes are going to be full of air.
Okay,
so what you do is push it. Yeah, the pump will push the air out through the tap. Okay, to fill your hot water tank, turn it to the hot side of your tap.
Mm-hmm.
Open it up. It does exactly the same. Obviously, there's a lot more. You've got about 10 litres of air inside that tank, so it'll take a bit longer for it to push that air out. Normally, what you'll find is it'll be spluttering like mad until you get this. Until you've got a solid stream like that, then you know your hot water tank's full. Okay?
Yep.
Hopefully you should have some hot water, If you want to put your finger under there, but it is...
You can see it. Lovely. It's
difficult to see steam in this time of year. Okay?
Yeah.
You're happy with that? Make sure you do that with each tap. Right. So you've got to make sure all the air's out, all the system. Otherwise, if you don't, you can hear the pump going then. That will continue to run. If there's air in the system, it'll just run and run until it squashes the air in it. And just continue to run until it does that. With water, obviously, it'll stop a lot quicker.
Okay. See, it's been spluttering, isn't it?
Yeah, it can just go. When it first kicks, it can get quite an explosion of air sometimes.
Yep.
So just be careful when you open the tap, just cautiously when you first
do
it. Okay?
Yep.
Right, so next thing to do is obviously heat the water. Obviously, if you want more water, that is. Right, this is a control panel. Okay, this is probably as complicated as you're going to get on this explanation, but okay, what I'll do, I'll just increase the temperature.
Is there like a thermostat on the heat
yes.
of the water?
Yeah, it has got a thermostat on it. Okay, right, so this is your main control panel for your heating and hot water.
Yeah.
That is the circulation pump running for your heating.
Yeah.
That is the to show that your electric's connected. So if you switch that switch off down there, that little plug disappears.
Okay.
So if that little plug's locked there, you haven't switched the electric on.
Okay.
Okay? Then the next one is just temperature. Okay, so your room temperature, which is 26 degrees.
Yep.
Okay, if you want to change anything, press the menu button. So the temperature, 30 maximum. So yep. 30 degrees maximum. If you want, obviously, this time of year, hopefully you won't need it on. All you need to do is just bring it below the temperature of the room.
Right.
Okay, so I've got it down to 20.5.
Yeah.
The room temperature is 26. The circulation pump's gone now.
Yeah.
So that means the heating's off.
Yeah.
Right.
Okay.
Nice.
Water heating.
Yep.
Okay, so that's your heating. All you do is just press up or down to whatever your preference your temperature is. Water temperature. So that's water heating off. Okay.
Yeah.
So that little triangle there is not coloured in.
Yeah.
And that little and the plus button is not green. Press that. That's your normal water heating running setting.
Right.
Okay, so green on, and you've got half a triangle coloured in.
Yep.
So that will obviously heat the water up to around about 70 degrees.
Yep.
If you want to boost the water, so if you want to do the washing up or use the shower, you want that extra bit of hot water, you can boost it.
Mm-hmm.
What that will do, it will boost, obviously concentrate all the heating on the hot water for around about 30 minutes. What it will also do at that particular time is shut the heating side of it down. So it'll concentrate all the heat on the hot water.
Right.
For that 30 minutes. After that 30 minutes, it will go back to revert back to the normal running on your water heating and allow the heating to come back on again.
Okay.
Okay. And you'll do that. Okay. The next two is what energy you're going to use. This one is for electric. So 1 kilowatt, 2 kilowatt, or 3 kilowatt.
Uh-huh.
You also got gas there. So that's gas off. That's gas on.
Okay.
It will let you know if the gas hasn't lit. It'll come up with two, like a yellow triangle and say gas failure. So if you haven't obviously turned the gas on or you run out of gas, obviously it will let you know.
Yeah.
Okay. So obviously check that if that does come up.
Okay.
Okay. In the winter, obviously this unit, obviously is heating your van and your water at the same time. So it's one unit does both.
Right.
So you imagine that's trying to heat up a cold room and cold water. It may struggle on electric alone. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
So you may have to run it on gas as well.
Okay.
So if you run it on both, what it'll do is it'll use both energies to get up to temperature. Then it'll shut the gas off and continue to run on electric.
Okay.
Okay? So it's not on gas all the time. It'll just run on electric. Tick, you know, obviously the electric's ticking over, keeping it warm. If someone like myself leaves the door wide open, let a blast of cold air in, or someone's used hot water out of the hot water tank.
Yeah.
Reduce temperature. Obviously, then it'll allow the gas to come back in and then boost it back up again.
Okay.
Okay. So that's mainly in the winter. In the summer, you're unlikely to want any heating anyway. So you're probably okay to run on a couple of kilowatts anyway, just enough to keep the water running.
Yeah.
Also, you've got to be aware of, in the winter, if you've got it on flat out on 3 kilowatts, and then you've got something else running like the electric ring and the microwave and someone else, or a hairdryer, it may overrun the bollard on site, because a lot of them have only got 16 amp, or some have got less.
Right,
and if you've got everything powered going flat out, the likelihood it'll just trip that, and then you'll have to get the warden out to come and say, just So you don't really particularly want to do that, but...
Yeah.
But it obviously it happens more in the winter.
Yeah.
Obviously you've got more heating and everything else going.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Happy with that bit?
Yeah. Well, and when we're moving, we turn that will turn off, won't it?
Yes.
When we turn that off.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. So always switch things off. Obviously, as soon as you unplug 240, obviously anything that was running on 240 will switch off anyway.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Happy you can switch that on, get the temperature up and down.
Yeah.
You need to.
Yeah. No problem
switch
with that.
On off. Okay.
Yep.
But there is a further menu. So I'll just go through this briefly, because if I give you too much information, you may overload, because I've obviously got other
possibly.
Things to do.
Yeah.
Well, I'll just go through what else there is there anyway. So if you want, there is timers on here. If you want to run any timers, you've got to set the clock, which is that one there.
Yeah.
This one is a reduced temperature. Normally at night time, you may want it. You can actually set it on a timer for a reduced temperature if you wanted to.
Yeah.
7-day timer is that one. A delayed timer is that one. So if you've got it on a seasonal pitch and you want to come back to it, say on Friday, you can actually set it to run.
Right.
Before you arrive, and obviously warmed up already before you get there. What it'll do then, if you obviously don't alter any of the If you don't alter the settings on it, it can actually run for 24 hours, and then it will switch itself off.
Yeah.
Okay. In 7 days' time, it can do exactly the same. So it's more like a 7 day, an individual day, if you know what I mean.
Yeah.
Prioritisation, that's what I was talking about when you got the two energies running and it shuts the gas off when it gets up to temperature. You can change the prioritisation on that if you wanted to, but I can't see why you would want to really. But obviously, after a few seconds, it goes back to your main screen. Calibration, obviously, the temperature is run on the thermostat. Obviously, if it thinks it's already 30 degrees and obviously it isn't, it's a lot colder, it obviously won't allow the heating to come on.
Mm.
So if you need to, you can calibrate it by doing that, your thermostat. Next one here, display. This may be of interest. Obviously, this is a normal setting, it's your bright screen.
Yes.
You can run it on dark if you want to, which is obviously dark.
Yeah.
Where you can press the screen and it will light up and show you what's running. So it's for nighttime running mainly, because some people get affected by, get disturbed by the light and it glows.
Sleeping.
So you can do that if you want to. Also, you can also what you call the invert, which is like a dark screen, but you can still see the icons. But the usual one is on the what you call the bright.
Yeah.
So I'll put it back to that one for now. Okay.
Yeah.
There's also this one here. If you have that switched on, it will come on automatically around about 2 o'clock in the morning. And actually boosts the temperature in the water to kill any bugs like Legionnaire's disease in it. Mm-hmm. This one is pump settings for the actual.
Why has that got the X across it? Is that?
I think it's killing the.
Oh right, okay.
So it's not.
Right, it's not.
I don't know if you've ever seen
not...
Batman. I don't know.
Okay,
no,
fine.
It's just like.
Yeah. Okay.
Okay, this one is your circulation pump settings. You can have it on continuous if you wanted to. So in the winter, you want it on continuously. But if you did do that, the likelihood you may struggle to get the temperature in your water, because it's obviously taking the heat off into the room all the time.
Right.
Or if you're trying to heat up the whole campsite. And then, this one is, every time you press the button, it goes beep. Language, if you want to talk French, German or Italian to it.
No.
you want to swear at it.
Yeah.
I might do a bit of French on that one. So external, this one that you can have, it's added extras you can buy where you can actually operate it off your phone. So you can actually remotely operate it using your phone. And the last one. Oh, this one here, obviously all these are grey, that's obviously they're not fitted.
Okay.
So they obviously don't do anything.
Yeah.
Then we've also got an important one is obviously reset.
Yeah.
So if anything's gone wrong with it or there's something you've been messing with and you're not sure what your rate of change, you can press that, it resets back to factory setting, which is as is now. Service button, that's what the guys use to set up the boiler and make sure it's operating temperatures and things like that.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And installed accessories, obviously the extra bits you can get fitted to the heating if you wanted to.
Yeah. That's fine.
There.
Okay. Lovely, yeah.
Hopefully I haven't given you too much information and